Okay, let us draw this diagram first and then we will discuss. Okay, now discuss this problem. So this says an uniform charge density, uniform volume charge density rho exists between the parallel planes z equals to a and z equals to minus a. So we have two plane surfaces. So this is z equals to a. So equation of this surface is z equals to minus a, and this surface is z equals to a, and this is z equals to 0. Now question says this a space that is between minus a to plus a has uniform charge density rho. Let us assume this is a positive charge. So this space is basically filled with positive charge. So this part of the space that is between z equals to plus a and z equals to minus a is filled with charge positive, and the volume density is given to you rho. So volume charge density that is given to you, that is rho. So volume charge density is given to you, and this is rho. Now the next part of the question says find the electric field in a space everywhere. So we have to find electric field in the space for all z. So we have to find electric field as a function of z. Now this is my z axis. So if I say this along this axis, if I look from this side, I will look only this. So let us make a cross sectional area. If I make cross sectional area, this will look something like this. So I will have this plane, another plane, another plane. So this is z equals to 0, and this is z equals to minus a, and this will be z equals to plus a. And now this region is filled with positive charge. So this is also filled with positive charge. And let us say my z axis is in the top direction. So this is my z axis. Are you getting or not? Now let us find electric field first at z equals to 0. So we are interested in finding electric field when z is equals to 0. So what will be the electric field when z is equals to 0? That is this plane. This is infinitely long. So this goes in this side infinite, this side infinite. So this plane is infinitely long. So you have to tell me what will be the z is equals to 0. Electric field, what will happen? The electric field, you have to give me the answer. I am waiting for 1 minute. There is nothing to do calculation. You can give the answer only by looking the symmetry. Now you know, if you consider any point on z equals to 0, if you consider this charge, this will try to push this charge this side. But equivalently, I can take symmetrically this side another charge, and this will try to push this side. So what will happen? The total force on this charge is zero. So if the total force on this charge is zero, I can say electric field at this point is zero. You take any charge. If you take this charge, there is symmetrically plus charge here. If you take this charge, there is... So for all charges between Z equals to 0 to A, there is a negative charge, there is a positive charge, symmetric positive charge, that is 0 to minus A. So I can say electric field at Z equals to 0 is 0. Now discuss electric field at Z, but Z is less than a small A. Now another point you see, the electric field Z equals to 0 to Z equals to A will be directed in this direction. Because any charge if I put here or here or here, it will push this side. But if you put a charge this side, it will push this side. So for Z equals to minus A, direction of electric field towards the minus Z axis. And for Z equals to positive A, that is Z equals to greater than Z, greater than 0, direction will be this side. Are you getting or not? And this will be symmetrical. So if I simply discuss the case between 0 to A, same thing will happen for 0 to minus A. Or if I discuss for greater than 0, I can always discuss Z is less than 0. Only thing will be direction will be opposite. So let us first discuss. I am discussing, we have discussed Z is equals to 0. Now a space can be divided into three reasons. First reason is Z is equals to 0. Second reason, Z is equals to 0 to A, and then Z is greater than A. So I am dividing my space into three reasons. So what are the reasons we have? So first reason is Z is equals to 0. And the second reason is Z is less than A. And third reason is Z is greater than A. So I am dividing the space into three reasons. First reason is Z equals to 0. I said Z equals to 0 is electric field is 0. Let us discuss the second reason, Z is less than A. So if I have my Z is less than A, I am somewhere here. I am somewhere here. So at this point, are you getting or not? So if I have Z is less than A, I am somewhere here. Now how to find electric field? Now I will use the Gauss law. So let us make a Gaussian surface, a pill box. So this is a surface, a pill box, cylindrical surface. One of the face lies in this plane and another face lies at Z is equals to 0. Are you getting it? So what is the my pill box? One part of one face of the pill box is inside this, another face as at Z is equals to 0. Now this height is Z. Are you getting it? So this height is basically Z. So let us first find flux. So you see, one can, okay, I am making the same thing here itself. So this is my Z is equals to 0. And this is my Z is equals to A. Now I am making my pill box somewhere here. So that one of the face lies on Z is equals to 0. Another face in the middle of this plane, that is Z is equals to Z. Now if I see electric field direction, one can symmetrically see the direction of electric field will be in the Z direction. So this is the direction of electric field. Try to see this one. If you put any charge here, it will be only repelled in the Z direction. You see, or the total force, or if you consider this charge, if I consider this charge, that will be repelled by this charge in this direction. And symmetrically, there will be charge that will be repelled by this direction. But totally, so this is have X component, this is X component. It will have only a Z component because X component will cancel. So symmetry says the direction of electric field will be only in the Z direction. Now if I consider the flux, so if I find flux, what will be the flux? So this is E is equals to 0. At this surface E is equals to 0. So for this, there will be no flux because E dot ds E is 0. So there will be no flux through this face. Through card face, card face will have area in this direction and electric field I have in this direction. So they are making a 90 degree. So this is my ds vector. This is my area E vector. And they are making angle 90 degree. So due to the card face, again flux will be 0. So that bottom face will contribute 0. Card face will contribute 0. Now about this phase. Now this phase will contribute. Now this is the E. And let us say area of this phase is A. So area of this phase is A. So it will contribute E into A. Why this is so? Because E is in this direction and ds is also in this direction. So E dot ds is 0, cos theta is 0. So E into A. Let me think yourself whether I have written the things are right or wrong. You just try to see yourself whether you understand this one or not. Now if we apply Gauss law, so total flux is equals to Q by epsilon naught, so total flux is E into A, and this is equals to Q by epsilon naught, so what is the Q? So area is A and Z is the volume, so total volume will be A into Z, and the charge density is rho. Are you getting? So A cancels out, so area and Q by epsilon naught, so this is the Gauss law, so electric field will be A goes out, so rho z by epsilon naught. So this will be the my electric field. Are you getting or not? Now if I consider third part of the space, that is electric field for z that is greater than A. Now in this case, what is my, where is my point? So I have z is equals to 0 axis, so z is 0 plane. And this is z is equals to A plane. Now if I choose a pill box, something like this. So this is my pill box. Now this height is again z. Now my z is greater than A. So this height is A, z is greater than A. Again I will say the same thing. Electric field on this face is directed this side E. And ds vector is also in this direction. Are you getting? So electric field as well as ds vector both are in this direction. So area vector as well as electric field vector both are in the perpendicular to this phase. So E dot ds is simply A. Now this will not contribute because E is 0. These are perpendicular. So this is area vector and this is the E vector. So this is the E vector and this is the area vector. And they are perpendicular to each other, so they will not contribute. So curved surface is not going to contribute. While this top face is going to contribute, and this will be E into A. So flux will be E into A. Now the only crux we have in this problem is charge. So what will be the Q? Now this time, this part does not contain any charge. So charge is only contained in this region. So what is the volume that contains charge? That is area into z, and that z is A because this region contains only charge. So Q I can write area into A into rho, that is the volume into volume charge density. Now I can write Gauss law E into A by Q by epsilon naught, so A into rho by epsilon naught. So A goes out, so you will have electric field that is A rho by epsilon naught. Now see, this is a constant. A is constant, rho is constant, so epsilon naught is constant, so this is constant. But the first part, that is electric field, we have calculated for this region, z is less than, so this is for z is less than A, that is linearly varying, that is not constant, this is a function of z. And this is z is greater than A, so now this is z is greater than A, this varies. Now I can summarize the whole thing. Electric field is 0 when z is 0. Electric field is rho z by A when z is less than A. And this is rho, electric field is rho into, so let me check here. So rho into A by epsilon naught. Here it should have epsilon naught also. So this is rho z by epsilon naught A. So this is rho z by epsilon naught. So naught A we have. Are you getting? Now next is rho A by epsilon naught we have. And when z is greater than A. Now I have a task. Can you plot these three electric fields? Electric field you have to take x axis as z and y axis or z axis as electric field. Plot this graph. So if you plot this one, it will look something like, so let us say this is my z axis, okay. Yeah, if I have z positive, and this is my electric field. So electric field, if z is 0, electric field is 0, we have already derived. If z is less than a, so this is a. If z is less than a, electric field varies linearly. So let us say this variation up to this is linear. And after this, this becomes constant. So that is this. You're getting or not? At z equals to, you see z equals to a, the function is continuous, because if you plug the value of z equals to a in this, you will get rho a by epsilon naught. Even if you plug in this a, so you will have rho a by epsilon naught. So that z equals to a, function is continuous. So I have electric field that is continuous. Now if I say, can you plot in the same graph for z equals to minus a? So what will be the directions? So you plot for z that is negative. So now you plot the graph for negative z. What kind of graph you will expect? So I have plotted the graph for z is greater than a. Can you plot for z is greater than 0. Now we have to plot z is less than 0. Now see, this thing is symmetrical. So you have to simply plot the graph. You have to use the symmetry. So only thing, direction of electric field will change and everything will remain same. So now this time electric field is positive. Now after that electric field will be negative. That is, we have already said, in this side electric field will be directed this side. In this case it will be directed negative side. So only thing is, magnitude by it will remain same, and the sign by it will reverse its sign. So you will have something like this, and then it will become constant. Once again, when z is equal to minus a, electric field will be continuous. So you will have this kind of graph. Now the question also asks, can you suggest me what is the potential? So we have to also find potential. And it is given as, so let us assume potential is 0 when z is 0. Now you use the expression minus dv over dz is equals to ez. So now I know the electric field, and then I can integrate. So what is dv? Dv is nothing but minus ez dz, and I have to integrate this expression, and I know electric field in the three region. I can find potential. So let us say I have z is equals to 0, so electric field, so let us say for electric field is 0, I have z is equals to 0, and I have also divided, that is the boundary condition is given to you, potential is also 0 when z is equals to 0. So this is given to you. So you assume potential is 0 when z is equals to 0. Now you have to find potential in another region of a space. So let us discuss the second reason. So E is rho z by epsilon naught when z is less than a. Rho z by epsilon naught, you see your answer in the back, you will get the same thing. Now I have to find potential. So what we will do is, I will use this expression, del v is equal to minus ez dz. And so let us integrate dv minus e is nothing but rho z by epsilon naught rho z dz. And I said when z is 0, potential is 0. I have to find potential when z is z. So this will be v is equals to minus rho z square by 2 epsilon naught. So you see, potential varies parabolic. Z square is parabolic expression. So I can say for z is less than a, potential is given as minus rho z square by 2 epsilon naught. So I can write here itself. So V is minus rho z by 2 epsilon naught if z is less than a. Now the third we have, third part of the space, that is z is greater than a. So for z is greater than a, I know the electric field, that is rho a by epsilon naught. And this is for z is greater than a, and we have to find potential for z is greater than a. Now use the same expression, so minus dv is equals to minus ez dz. 0 to V and this will be 0 to Z. So this will be V and Ez is nothing but rho A by epsilon naught that is given to you into dz 0 to z. So this will be V is equals to minus rho Az by epsilon naught. So you see this time our potential varies linearly. So now I can divide the potential. So potential is 0 when z is equals to 0. Potential is minus rho A. So let me check. So this is rho z square by epsilon 2 epsilon naught. So minus rho z square by 2 epsilon naught, not A. Rho z square by 2 epsilon naught when z is less than A. And potential is rho Az by epsilon naught when z is greater than A. So I have the potential function. So potential is again, you can check whether this potential at different region of a space is same or not. So basically you can plot the graph. So let us plot the graph for this function. Basically there is a mistake. Here for z is greater than A, I have to do this integration not from 0 to z. I have to do this integration from A to z. Are you getting? Because my z is greater than, that's why I am not getting the same thing. So if z is greater than A, I have to do integration from A to z. And I have to add another term, that is rho Az by epsilon naught dz 0 to A. Are you getting or not? Because I want to find potential at z, but z is greater than A. So now this time I can divide the same thing in two parts of the function, A to 0 to A and A to z. Are you getting or not? So what I want? I want 0 to z, but A is greater than A. Z is has two kind of function. If z is less than A, I have different function. Z is greater than A, I have different function for electric field. So what I will do is I will change this is 0 to A plus A to z, because I have different function for electric field. So when I have 0 A to z, I have different function, that is rho A by epsilon naught. When I have 0 to A, I have this electric field function. So this will be plus a minus also, of course. So whole I will have minus throughout, I will have minus. So let us put a minus sign throughout, because this minus is minus dz. So we will have rho Az by epsilon naught, and this will be rho Az square by 2 epsilon naught. Are you getting? So I have to add this term. So rho Az by epsilon naught plus rho Az square by 2 epsilon naught. Are you getting or not? Let me check. So this is z, z minus a, because you can have upper limit is z, lower limit. So this is z minus a. So here you will have z minus a, and one term will be added plus rho a z square by 2 epsilon naught. Rho a z square by 2 epsilon naught. So let us write again the same thing. I will write again. So I am writing potential. Potential is 0 when z is 0. Potential is minus rho z square by 2 epsilon naught when z is less than a. And potential is rho a z minus a by epsilon naught. This with minus sign, so you will have minus here. So throughout I have a minus, so let us plug a minus here as well as minus here, because this is minus is multiplied throughout, so I have to multiply by minus. Minus rho a z square by 2 epsilon naught. So minus rho a z square by 2 epsilon naught, and this is for z is greater than a. Now let us check this value. If I have z is equals to a, this term will be 0, and this will be not z square, I think rho a z. So let us see what we have. So this is not a rho z square simply. Again, we have another so many mistakes. So this is not rho a, not a. there will be nodes A, because this is incorrect dimensionally. This is incorrect dimensionally. So there will be node A. Now if I plug value of z, so let us check the continuity at z equals to a. So z equals to a, we will have from this function rho a square by 2 epsilon naught. From this function, this will be 0. Again, you will have rho a square by 2 epsilon naught. This means that z equals to a, function is, potential is continuous. So, and that's why I have to see very carefully whether I have to integrate from 0 to a plus a to z, or I have to integrate simply 0 to z, because electric field changes in this region. 0 to a I have different electric field, and a to z I have different electric field. If somebody says plot this function potential versus z, can you plot this one? So I need to plot potential on the y axis and z on the x axis. So can you plot this function? So let us take some time, and things will be very simple. So you have to plot z equals to 0 to a first, so 0 to a. Now you know, from 0 to a, this is a parabolic variation, so rho z square by 2 epsilon naught, and this is a negative, so you will have a parabolic variation 0 to a, and then you will have a linear variation, so you will have linear variation, something like this. Are you getting? So this is a parabolic, this is linear. And the things will be very similar for negative z. Only thing is, now z is negative, so this is for positive z, and potential will be negative again, so you will have something of this kind of thing. Are you getting? So for minus z, you can verify yourself, you will get the same graph. So what are the important point in this question we have? The first important point we have, that is, I have to use the symmetry and I have to decide electric field is 0 at z is equals to 0. That is the first part. Now the second part, I have to divide my space into three regions basically. Z is equals to 0 is only one plane. Now I have to divide z is equals to 0, 0 to a and a to z. If my z lies between 0 to a, and if my z lies between greater than a, that is the three part of the space. And then I have to use the Gauss law. I have to make a pillbox, I have to consider the charges, use the flux, is equals to q by epsilon naught, you will get E. Now the third part of the question says finding potential. So finding potential, I will use V is equals to minus E dz integral. So let us finish it here. This is a quite good problem. We'll discuss the next problem.